Good evening.
All right. So, how are you today, people? How was everything?
I'm fine, teacher. And
Fine.
you? And you? And you?
Yeah, very good. I'm just I had like 10 minutes that I came to my house from work. It was like a lot of traffic. So, yeah, I mean, I came here like a little bit late, but thanks God we are like here, right? Right, but you know, right after a hard day, we are here just to finish the last shift. It means like to finish this class. And how do you feel now, Maritza?
I'm fine, teacher. Very good.
Really?
Yeah, I'm
You don't have any symptom now?
stable. Stable.
No, okay.
Un poco de cansancio en por la mañana.
You feel like
Leve, pero sí lo tuve. Y el resto del día he estado bastante bien estable.
I mean, that's pretty cool. It means like, you know, like the symptoms are lowing down.
Yeah,
Yeah, I mean, they will
yeah.
disappear in a couple of days, I think. That's cool. That's really cool. Yeah, that's really nice. So let's see. What the other one says. Hi. Hi, William. How's everything?
Hi.
How have you been?
So.
So-so? All right. Now, you're in your house already?
Don't
Okay, but are you home right now, William? Are you in your house?
In my house, yes.
Okay.
I stay in my house
Nah.
the last night. I didn't the class.
Yeah, I mean, I saw
I
that you
don't stay
didn't.
in the class.
Last class, yeah, I remember that. I didn't see you in the class last night. Okay. You had to work last night?
Yes,
Ah, so then
I
that's why.
was born.
Okay. Yeah. Well, I mean, that's pretty cool. But the good thing is that you're here now, right? Just to see, let me see. Just to finish with week number two now. So what we're gonna be doing today is just basically a general feedback from all the topics that we have been discussing during the week. It means from the past Thursdays till today. Actually, yesterday. Yesterday was the last topic that we were discussing. So today what we're going to have is just a general feedback from everything we had during the week. So let's wait for the rest of the classmates to come up to the class and we can start. So let me see, we just got Rosa. Hi, Rosa. All right, so we got Rosa there, we got Carla, Ruth, and Jennifer. Are you there, people? So let's see. Let me check. I'm loading the attendance list just to start because we have a lot of information to share tonight. All right. Some of you, I was watching that some of you got some troubles, right? With you got some troubles with the homework. with some parts of the homework, especially from the exercise 9. But I guess you solved them all, right? I guess you could solve all the problems from that section. Supongo que lograron resolver ese pequeño inconveniente de algunas oraciones que están
en... Good evening, everyone.
Hi, Ever. Good evening. Están en el ejercicio de la tarea 9. I don't know if you could solve them all. Or do you still have some problems with that? Ever, did you solve all the exercises from the homework number 9?
Homework number 9. No. I finished that.
Ah, okay. Yeah, because I was reading some text messages in the group, and some of you couldn't finish them because some exercises were wrong, apparently.
Well, let me see. I was a problem only in the midterm and the fourth parts for the one, first and second question.
Mm-hmm.
I find the correct answer about this.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Ah, okay. I think that's the same problem that everybody were into. I was about to say, I was about to ask who's Andrea Cristales, but now I remember it's Nubia. Hi, Nubia. Let's change your name, Nubia.
This moment, change the name, teacher.
Okay, okay, good. So let's see. Diana, Jennifer, Carla, Ruth, are you there?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Okay. I got an extra student there. Hi, Carla. All right. There you go. So you got them in there. Let's see, just Ruth and Jennifer probably are not completely there. I can see the new student there. Hi.
I don't know.
Okay, all right. You don't know. Okay.
Dice que también es mi alumna.
Ah, sí, sí. Claro que sí, también es mi alumna.
Entonces ahora sí lo entiendo.
Much understand me. Yeah, okay, okay. There you go. So, hi, Jennifer.
Good evening.
Good evening.
En la jauría de la colonia.
Okay. Yeah. I mean, I can listen. Okay. I mean, you are very well protected.
Sure. Yo tuve problemas con la parte 4 del midterm, pero no sé si le sirva a compañeras que le quiten el punto. Porque ahí, bueno, yo entendería, ¿verdad?, que iba a llevar el punto. Y lo intenté con el punto, lo intenté con la mayúscula al principio, pero le quité el punto.
And it worked.
Sí. Yeah.
Ah, uh-huh. Yeah, I mean, in some of them... what you have to do is just like to eliminate the dot, okay? And in some of them, just to eliminate the capital letter into the lowercase letter. And also, in some of those exercises, you have to change them. In some of them, you have to eliminate the like in good like. And in some of them, you have to put it, okay? You have to try out from different ways. Just to complete it. But the good part is like most of you have already finished that part. Okay, and I'm pretty satisfied with that. Okay, so I think we're gonna start because we have a lot of information to provide a feedback. So, and the rest of your classmates can join during the process. I'm gonna start with the attendance list just to start. But let's see, Ana Claribel. All right, we don't have right here. Ana Maria, I think she's coming late. Carlos Ademir is not here. Eric Guillermo, probably Eric got problems because he usually comes early. All right, probably he's not here because something happened. Ever de Jesus?
Present teacher.
Okay, good. Fatima Alejandra. We don't have here. Hilmar Cruz. Let me see if I can have Hilmar here. No, I don't have it. Jonathan Alexander. Okay. Nah, I don't have it, right? Okay, so we're gonna wait for him. Jorge Elvir, he usually comes kind of late. Carla Benazir.
Present teacher.
Nah, okay, good. Marga Fernandez, basically she disappeared. Maritza Alcira.
Chair, present teacher.
Okay, good. Natalie Vanessa, she usually comes late. Romeo Alexis, no here. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
Okay, thank you. Ros Joana.
Present teacher.
Okay, very good. Sara Carolina, she's not here yet. Stephanie Lisette, neither her. Vanessa Odette, she's not here yet. William Alberto.
Present.
Okay, good. Let me check. Roxana Yesenia.
Present teacher.
Hi, Roxana. You look so tired, Roxana. Nuria Zulema.
Present teacher.
Okay. There you go. Jennifer Noemi.
Present.
All right. Who would you like to be called, Jennifer? Just Jennifer or just Noemi?
Jennifer.
Okay. Not Noemi.
Not.
Why not?
No mi preferido.
But I mean.
Pero podría atender si me dicen Noemi. No hay problema.
Okay. Because there are a lot of people that they usually hate the second name. That's why I was asking. Let's see, Diana Gabriela.
Present teacher.
Okay. Hey, no la dejo participar.
No, no la dejé, siempre dice lo mismo.
Present teacher.
Hi. Okay.
I don't know.
No, hombre, enséñale otra palabra a la niña.
Vaya, teacher, yo se la enseño.
Ahí está, ok, good.
Para que le hable después.
Ya, ya. I mean, no, just pretty cool. Ok, good. Listen, people, what are we going to do today? Today, we're going to basically have a general feedback from the whole topics that we were discussing during the week. It means that today we're going to start off with practice only, all right? About the uses of those structures that we were supposed to be studying and we were supposed to be practicing in every video conference, right? That we have related to the second week. Right after we read a series of example sentences that I bring that are basically in your manuals, okay? Right after that, we're gonna be starting working in some breakout rooms because we are going to do some activities with those structures, okay? So what are we gonna be doing? We're gonna read examples that you have already right in that case in your notebook, okay? And we just check, okay? Just, you know, to refresh your mind about those specific topics. And right after that, we are going to do some activities in there, in the manual, Okay. So that's why the topic is vocabulary practice. Okay. Vocabulary and practice. That's the topic from the this video conference number 10. All right. Let's remember that at the end of this class, you were supposed to have the homework number 10 already finished, and also the midterm, okay? Both grades, I'm gonna be uploading them by the end of the class, or right after, you know, like the class hour. What are we gonna have? As I told you, the first thing that we're gonna be discussing or reading or whatever you wanna say, it's, you know, like a general feedback from the previous topics, right? The four topics that we were discussing. Right after that, we're gonna read some series of examples in the manual, okay? Right after that, we're gonna work in some activities in the manual. And after working in those activities, we're gonna check them. Gonna check those activities, okay? And this is pretty much what we have, right? It's like nothing new for us because this is just feedback, okay? Okay, let's start with the demonstrative pronoun. Why the demonstrative pronouns? Because this was the first topic that we were discussing last Thursday, if you remember, okay? What are the demonstrative pronouns? Let's see if you remember. Vamos a ver si recordamos. Cuando hablamos de pronombres demostrativos or demonstrative pronouns, what are we talking about? Or what are they about? Do you remember them? What are them? ¿Podrían mencionármelos, por favor?
There.
Kind of. Something like that, but it's not the right one, William. There are four.
Is this?
These, those?
That, these, and those.
That. There you go. We got this and that. This and that. This and that.
Those.
These and those, exactly. If you remember, people, we used to have four of them. We got these and we got that. When do we use them? We use them with singular nouns, okay? Then we got these and we got those. When do we use them? Good evening, for plural nouns, all right? Hi, good evening. Ah, let me see who's speaking. Ah, Jorge. Hi, Jorge.
And yes,
hi,
it's Gilmore. Me.
Yeah, I mean, both come late. Thank you. What were you doing, people? Porque se conectaron los dos al mismo tiempo, huh?
I don't know. Huh. I am going... voy llegando de mi casa, del trabajo.
Suspicious people. Suspicious. But you didn't go to Sara's work, right? No? Aren't you coming from there? No van llegando el trabajo de Sara? Ah, okay.
Ah, no.
Okay, there you go.
No. Pusimos de ahí de conejillos de India, pero...
Okay.
Really?
All right.
Okay. No problem.
Okay, there you go. Now, what do we remember from this and that, these and those, people? Let's remember, this and that, it's for things, remember, that are close and are singular. Okay, example, a book, a computer, a purse, Okay. A is student. Sorry. There you go. Okay, these ones are singular nouns. Okay, these and those. Okay, check this out. These and those are different. But this one, check this out. When do we use this? We use it for something that we got close and are singular. Okay, that's for this. Now, using that. When do we use that? Were far things and are singular. Okay. And we got the same. A tree, a fan, a cell phone, for example. Okay. Then we got this. When do we use this? For plural objects or nouns that are close to me. Okay. Example, books, computers, this is plural, okay? Cell phones, and then we got those. When do we use those? For plural nouns that are far from me. Example, let's put tables, chairs, jobs. Okay, check this out. When do we apply them into examples? Take this out. This computer is excellent. Listen up. This computer is excellent. The computer is close from me. La computadora, en este caso, está cerca de mí. Okay, that's why I can write down this computer, okay? And I want you people to pay attention to this because we are going to do an activity that involves this type of examples, okay? Quiero que ponga mucha atención porque más adelante vamos a hacer una actividad que requiere el uso de este tipo de pronombres, okay? So try to pay attention, and if you have any questions, please let me know, okay? Or ask. Okay. This computer is excellent, okay? The computer is close from me, all right? Significa que en este caso la computadora está cerca de mí. Por eso uso this, and it's only one. That purse is expensive. That purse is expensive. Ese bolso es caro. You see, what happened in this case? The purse is far from me. Okay, what happened in this case? Que ese bolso del que yo estoy hablando, que está caro, está lejos de mí. Okay, es algo que no tengo en mi mano. Algo que no puedo tocar en el momento. Okay, it's something I don't have in my hand. It's far from me, está lejos de mí. Entonces, uso that, okay? In that case, use that. Let's suppose, I'm gonna give an extra example. Listen in this case. Si yo les pregunto a ustedes, listen, what is this? What is this? ¿Qué es esto? Estoy usando la primera estructura, que en este caso sería este. This. What is this? Como lo tengo cerca de mí, yo puedo decir this. Porque está cerca de mí y lo puedo tocar. Right? This. What is this? All of you, your answer starts with that. Entonces, su respuesta, cualquiera de ustedes que me dé la respuesta, la pueden comenzar con that. Why? Porque de ustedes está lejos el celular que tengo acá. Está lejos de ustedes. Entonces ustedes no me van a responder con this. This is your cell phone. No, you're going to answer that is your cell phone. Okay? That is your cell phone. In that case, that will be your answer, okay? Check this out. I'm going to put the example in here. I'm going to make this a little bit up. Give me a second. I'm going to put it in here so you can understand a little bit better this structure. I'm going to put this like in here. Okay, extra examples. Check this out. My question is this one. What is this? Okay, and I show the cell phone to you. What is this? So your answer will be, that is your cell phone. You see? That will be your answer, okay? That is your cell phone. Ah, ese es su o tu celular. There you go. Good. Esto, aplicándolo en, ya en contexto, put it into context, okay? In question and answers. Aquí pues ya va, prácticamente estamos practicando ambos. This and that. This in the question, that in the answer. What is this? Ah, that is your cell phone. Or that is a cell phone. Ah, eso es un celular. Okay, good. Entonces acá, en la pregunta y respuesta, básicamente tenemos las diferencias entre ellos. This, cuando algo está cerca, lo puedo tocar, lo puedo agarrar con mi mano. I can grab it with my hand. Okay? It, because it's close for me. Let's remember that. That is for something that is far from you. Ah, that es para algo que tenemos lejos, que no podemos agarrar con nuestra mano en el momento de hablar. Okay? At the moment of speaking, you cannot say like, you know, like that when you have something in your hand. You cannot do that. You can use that when something is far, far from you. Cuando algo está lejos de ustedes, okay? Just keep that in mind. And besides that, remember, we use this and that only for singular nouns, okay? Only with one object, one place, one person, okay? Just like that. Only in singular, okay? Just singular. Okay, now, I want you to show something, the things that you got from the air, okay? Ahora, ¿qué vamos a hacer? Listen. De algo que tengan a la mano ahí cerca, and in the case only one, quiero que tomen un objeto y ustedes, sin escribir, without writing on the books or notebooks, quiero que me, quiero que levanten ese objeto cuando yo les mencione y ustedes me van a hacer esa pregunta. What is this? Y alguien más de sus compañeros va a responder, ¿ok? Pero para ello necesito que todos tengan sus cámaras encendidas, ¿ok? Because, I mean, I cannot say what is this with my camera off, right? So I want everybody to turn on your cameras, please, ¿ok? Good. Who I'm going to start with? I'm going to start with Maritza and Ever. Maritza, can you show something to the camera and then ask the question?
¿Con quién me toca?
With Ever. Ever is going to answer to that question.
Ever, okay. What it is?
Maritza, that is a pen.
That is a pen. Okay, very good. Thank you, Maritza. Now, Ever, show something to the camera, and I want Nubia to answer that question.
Okay. I don't have anything, Nubia, near from
me. Come on, man. You got the cap in here. You got the cap in your hand.
Okay. No.
You can point at the cap.
Yeah. Nubia, what is this?
¿Qué? ¿Qué? No veo.
I don't even identify that, I mean, from here. Ah, okay. All right. The one that you control the computer with?
Mouse.
Yes.
Ah, okay. That's your mouse?
That is your mouse. Okay. Oh, that is a mouse. Okay. There you go. Thank you, Ever. Now, Nubia, show something to the camera, and Carla is going to give you the answer.
What is this?
Carla?
This is your watch.
Do you have it in your hand, Carla?
¿Me escucha, teacher?
Yes, Carla.
Okay, that is your watch.
Ah, okay, very good. That is your watch. There you go, very good. Thank you, Nubia. So now, Carla, I want you to grab something and show it to the camera, and Jorge is going to give you the answer, okay?
Okay, George, what is this?
I mean, George, in English. Good, man. Good.
I don't see anything.
No.
Carla. What's up, Carla? Ah, yeah, I mean, yeah.
It's the shadow. That is your shadow.
Oh,
no, man. There are headphones. Headphones.
Headphone.
Right? Yeah.
That is yes. Your. That is yes, your teacher. Headphone? I don't see any.
Yeah, I mean, that is a. Is that a camera, Carla?
Is the mouse?
Voy a cambiar.
Okay.
Ah, better, because
that is your cell phone.
Ah, okay. That is your cell phone. There you go. Because it's far Carla, from you, right?
That is your cell phone.
Thank you, Carla.
And your shadow.
Okay. There you go. Thank you, Carla. Now, Jorge, show something to the camera, and Hilmar is going to answer the question.
Hilmar. Hello, Hilmar.
Hello, Jorge.
Okay. What is this?
I mean, that's a lime?
Orange?
No. Something similar.
¿Cómo se dice mandarina?
Mandarin?
Mandarin.
No, mandarin. It's tangerine.
Mandarin.
It's tangerine?
Tangerine.
That tangerine? No.
I recognize like mandarin.
Yeah, mandarin.
Mandarine. That's the written form, right? Mandarin?
Okay. Yeah, it's correct.
Ah, okay, okay. Okay, good. That's a mentoring ring. There you go. Now, Hilmar, show something to the camera, and Roxana is going to give you the answer to the question that you will ask.
What is this?
Ah, okay.
That is... Ay, no sé cómo dice taza.
Cup. Cup. Yeah.
Cup?
Yeah, cup.
That is cup.
That's a cup. All right, there you go. Thank you, Hilmar. Now, Roxana, show something to the camera, and Fatima will answer to the question that you will ask. Roxana.
What is this?
Okay, good.
Ay, no sé cómo se dice, un peluche. That is
a teddy bear. Teddy bear.
Teddy bear. That is your teddy bear.
Ah, okay. Bear. Okay. There you go. That is your teddy bear. All right. Okay. Good. There you go. Thank you, Rosana. All right. Fatima, show something to the camera, and Carlos will answer the question.
Okay, what is this?
Jesus Christ, what is that? I don't even recognize that.
For me, maybe in the butter. And
is that a butter?
In the chocolate?
That is a butter.
A bottle of a bottle with chocolate?
Drinking.
Okay, that is
I a see good. With chocolate.
All right. There you go. Okay, thank you, Fatima. That was weird. All right, but it was okay. Carlos shows something to the camera, and Jonathan will answer to your question.
Jonathan, what is this?
Vaya, teacher, yo como me acabo de conectar.
I thought it was an egg.
Necesito entenderle.
Ah, okay. Ah, yeah, I mean, usted no estaba, ¿verdad? En la clase. There you go. So, try to catch what your classmates are doing, okay? So, Jennifer, answer that question from Carlos, please. So, Jonathan, pay attention to it. Carlos, can you ask again the question, Carlos? And
what is this?
What is that? Es la... Para los audífonos, no sé ni yo, yo tengo uno, pero no sé cómo se llama.
Yes.
In English, teacher.
That's the earbud box. Earbud box.
Ear box.
Earbud.
Earbuds box. Box.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
All right.
Okay.
The one that can act like a charger. All right. There you go. Thank you, Carlos. Now, Jennifer. So zoomed into the camera, and Diana will answer that question.
Okay, Diana, what is this?
Se dice.
Teacher, is nail polish?
Nail polish, that, yeah.
That is your nail polish.
Nail polish.
Nail polish.
Ah, okay, there you go. Thank you, Jennifer. Now, Diana, choose something from there close to you, all right? And Rosa will answer that question.
Okay. What is this, Rosa?
That is
a hair dryer.
That is hair dryer.
Okay, a hair dryer, right? I think that is that's secadora, right? I don't get along pretty much with that. Okay, there you go.
Es un arma de fuego.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean,
what is it?
Little one, man. Okay. There you go. Thank you, Diana. Now, Rosa, show something to the camera and let's see. William, we'll answer.
Fácil. What is this?
Easy one. Okay.
This is frijoles chips.
No, but remember, this es para algo que tiene cerca ahí con usted, William.
That is frijoles chips.
Okay. O de una manera general, that is a snack.
Snack. That is a snack.
There you go. Very good. Now, thank you, Rosa. Now, William, show something to the camera and let me see. Who can tell you? Not Jonathan. Now, Jonathan. I think Jonathan can answer the question.
Okay. What is this?
Okay. Good.
That is mouth.
That is.
That is mouth.
A mouse. No, man, the one that William is showing to the camera. The object that William is showing to the camera, Jonathan. El objeto que William está mostrando a la cámara.
Pero no me sale.
You got it?
No.
¿No le sale lo que William está mostrando?
Un clock. That is clock.
That is a clock. Very good. There you go. Thank you, William. Now, Jonathan, let me see who's missing. Ruth, are you there?
Yes, teacher.
Okay. Ruth, can you please turn on? Ah, okay. There you go. Jonathan, choose something near from you, okay, and show it to the camera and ask the question, and Ruth will answer.
What is this?
Okay. That is a cell phone.
Okay, very good. Thank you, Jonathan. Now, Ruth, I want you to finish the cycle. Grab something and ask the question, and Maritza is going to answer.
Okay. Hello, Maritza. What is this?
Very good. Maritza?
¿Con quién me toca?
Conmigo.
Ruth is showing the object.
Con Ruth.
What is this?
That is a book?
Yes.
Okay, very good. Yeah, that is a book. What is this? There you go. Okay, that is a book. So we finish the cycle with that. And remember, that for something that is far from you and is only one object, and this for something that you have in your hand is close from you and is singular, okay? You get it like very, very close from you. Let's see some examples in this case. The ones that you have in the manual. These ones are the ones that you have in the manual. Okay, it says singular. There you go. Now, Jonathan, help me on reading the first example, please.
I want to buy this computer.
Nah, okay. In this case, remember, if I say, I want to buy this computer, es porque la computadora está cerca de donde yo estoy. Inclusive, a lo mejor puedo estarla revisando. I can be checking the computer and everything. So that's why I can say, I want to buy this computer, okay? That's the way how we use it. There you go. Second example, Rosa. Rosa, are you there?
Yes.
Okay.
We checked this cell phone on the webpage.
Nah, okay, thank you. We checked this cell phone on the webpage, it means, right? We got the cell phone on the screen and everything. You say, look, we checked this cell phone on the webpage, right? Like, revisamos este celular en la página web. There you go. It's because it's something that you get very close from you. Okay. Then we got the third example. Viana, help me on reading the third example. Viana?
Yes, teacher.
All right. Read example number three.
Okay, sería, she is going to order that kit for her friends.
Okay, there you go. Thank you, Diana. She is going to order that kit for her friend. Why do we use that? ¿Por qué usamos that? Because it's very far from the person that is speaking. Remember that. Porque no está cerca, relativamente hablando, okay, de la persona que lo está mencionando. Okay. It's pretty far from it. That's why we use that. And then let's read the last example. Vanessa, let's read the last example, please.
Okay.
The company wants to buy that leaf.
Ah, okay, very good. The company wants to buy that leaf. There you go. So in this case, it's because it's kind of far from the person that is speaking, right? That's why we use that. Pero recuerden, en todos ellos, usando this and that, solamente nos referimos a singular nouns, only one, okay? What happened in plural? In plural is pretty simple. Again, right? This is the plural version. We use this and those, okay? ¿Cómo podemos comparar o cómo podemos saber cuándo usar this para singular and this para plural? Easy. Lo vamos a identificar por la forma del verbo to be. Okay? For the form of the verb be. Remember, with singulars, we use is. This is a cell phone. This is a computer. Okay? We use is. With these related to plural, we use are. Okay? Because are represents the plural version. Okay? Example, these are my shoes. Estos son mis zapatos. Something that I have close from me. Okay? So, vamos a usar these are cuando tengamos más de un objeto del cual estamos hablando. Now, it's not singular. It's plural. Okay? Let's suppose I have two cell phones. One in each hand. And I can say, hey people, what are these? Ahora ya no es what is this, es what are these, ¿ok? En ese caso, ustedes me dirían those, because those is the one that takes place of that. Those actúa como that, solo que those es para plurales, that es para singulares, ¿ok? Let's keep that different. So you will say, those are cell phones. Esos son celulares. O those are your cell phones. O esos son sus o tus celulares. Okay? But that represents a plural. Why? Because probably in my hand I have two cell phones, three cell phones, four cell phones, whatever, right? But indicates plural. There you go. These are for something close. Para algo cerca que tengo. Que puedo tocar, ok, que puedo manejar. Those are para algo lejos que está de mí y significa que estoy hablando de más de un producto, ok. There you go. We got the examples in here. Check this out. You have to buy these shoes, ok. Tienes que comprar estos zapatos. It's because the person who is saying the example is close from the shoes. Okay. Probablemente la persona que haya dicho esa oración esté cerca de los zapatos. Okay, that's why that person uses his. Okay, I mean this. Then we got the second example. And for the second example, I want Romeo to help me a reading. Romeo?
Un ejemplo me dijo, ¿no?
Yeah, example number two, read.
Okay, he can pay with an of this credit card.
Okay, he can pay with any, Romeo, any of these credit cards.
Any of the credit cards.
Okay, very good. There you go. What are you representing in there, Romeo? You are representing a plural version. Why? Because in this case, you are talking about more than one, listen up, more than one credit card, okay? More than one credit card, okay? There you go. Roxana, let's read the example number three.
They purchased.
They purchased, uh-huh.
Those cars.
Yeah. It's like, ellos compraron esos carros. There you go. Probably when you're talking about those cars, they are far from you, okay?
I need one.
Yeah, me too. I need a new one. There you go. So then we got the last example, and the last example is going to be read by Ruth. Are you there? Let's read the last example. The last example.
Ay, she's a mildito.
My.
What? ¿Cómo es?
Now in there, read the last example in the screen. El último ejemplo.
Ah, lo leo, nada más.
Yes.
My co-workers sold those products.
Okay, let's read again. My co-workers sold those products.
Sold those products.
Okay, very good. What is that? In that case, it says my co-workers sold these products. All right, those products in that case. We're talking about plural, right? ¿Por qué? Porque estamos hablando de más de un producto, okay? Vendieron esos productos. There you go. And why do we use those? Because probably at the moment of speaking, the product was far, okay? They were far from the person who was speaking, okay? Good.
What's up, Claudia?
Okay, good. What are we gonna do? Listen. Now that we have known the uses of this and that, these and those, okay, do you have any questions before moving on? Antes de movernos a otro review, do we have any question with this? ¿Tenemos alguna pregunta con relación a la estructura de este tema? Demonstrative pronouns? Something that might not be clear for you? ¿Algo que no esté de todo claro? Okay. If nothing is, you know, making have doubts, let's continue. Let's start the uses of can. What do we remember from the auxiliary verb can? What is can used for? ¿Cuándo usamos can? Give me only one way to use can.
Or
abilities.
Permission.
For abilities and permissions. There you go. Very good. Abilities. I can swim. Puedo nadar. That is an ability that almost anybody has it, right? En este caso, hablamos de habilidades que nosotros poseemos y que es fácil para nosotros el poderlas hacer, okay? Example, I can cook lasagna, for example, right? Not everybody can cook lasagna. No todos pueden hacerlo. So that is an ability that you people have, okay? So a request, ahora expresando una solicitud, a request or permission. Can I do the homework right after the class? ¿Puedo hacer la tarea después de clase? You see, in that case, you use can when asking for permission, okay? Ahí básicamente estamos solicitando que una especie de permiso, all right? O estamos haciendo una, how can I say this, especie de solicitud, okay? Using, of course, as I told you, can. We got some examples in here, okay? Carla, let's read example number one.
Okay. I can give you my personal information.
Okay, I can give you my personal information, right? Puedo darle mi información personal. There you go. Now you cannot give your personal information because, all right, different reasons, right? You know. But that's one way. What are we doing in that case? By saying I can give you my personal information in the case you are, you know, like offering something, okay, that belongs to an ability to someone. Now let's read example number two. And for example number two, I want Ana Garcia to read.
Excuse me, teacher.
Ana García.
Teacher, Ali. Excuse me.
Ajá, Jorge.
I need allow me to the answer for the class for 5 minutes, please. I need attendance, one problem in my house.
Ah, okay, all right. All right, Jorge.
Okay, thank you.
Okay. Ajá, Ana. Go on.
She can't. No, she can't.
She can't. Uh-huh. That's negative.
She can't pay for the washer.
Uh-huh.
Right now.
Ah, okay. That is what? That is expressing something that you cannot do, right? She can't pay for the washer right now. ¿Qué estamos expresando en ese caso? Something that you are not affordable to pay, right? So that's use of an ability, but in a negative form. And what is the negative form in that case? The uses of can plus not. She can't pay for the washer right now. Ella no puede pagar la lavadora en este momento. So what that means, that's an ability that she cannot develop at the moment of speaking. Okay, good. Now let's read the next example. Actually it is example number three. Vanessa, help me reading, please. Vanessa? Hello, Vanessa.
Sorry, teacher, in my internet.
Ah, okay, good.
Oh, hello.
I thought it was not your internet. I thought it was you that were like this. I thought you were sleeping or something like that.
Okay, number three.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Can I have your credit card number?
Ah, okay, very good. Like, can I have your credit card number? What are you asking in there? Asking for very specific information, right? Ahí estamos solicitando información. Okay, can I have your credit card number? Not right. Impossible. There you go. Thank you, Vanessa. Now, Jennifer, let's finish the reading.
Can you tell me how many items you need?
All right, can you tell me how many items you need? All right, there you go. In that case, what are we asking in that case? We are asking about very specific information, okay? Entonces ahí básicamente lo que estamos haciendo es preguntar sobre información bien, bien, bien específica. Where can we find these extra examples? You can find them in the manual, right? In the manual section from there. You can take them from there. Okay, good. Let's continue. We got could. Do we remember the uses of could? Ah, could is the past form. Listen, could is the past form of the verb can. Could básicamente es la forma pasada del verbo auxiliar can. And when do we use it for? Ah, we can use it for, okay, to talk about activities or abilities, in this case, in the past. Okay? And also when referring to question, we can use them to show any kind of, let me check. Ah, okay. You can use it, you know, to ask for very, very specific information or request very specific information. Let's see the examples that we got it. That these examples are taken from the manual, remember, right? The uses of cool. Nubia, help me out reading the first example.
¿Cuál, teacher?
Example number one.
Oh, okay. You could try with another credit card.
Now, okay. You could try with another credit card, right? Ah, podría intentar con otra tarjeta de crédito. Probably in that case, you are not, I mean, the card that you gave is not passing, right? The payment method. And you have to change the credit card. There you go. Now, let's read the example number two. Jonathan, help me on reading, please.
Could you spell your last name?
Right, they couldn't give you.
Okay, they couldn't give you my billing address.
Ah, okay, very good. They couldn't give you my billing address. Ellos no le pudieron dar mi dirección. Okay, you know, like the correo or the pago. There you go. So we got it in negative. What do we do in that case? Just put cool plus not together. Couldn't, okay, just to talk about past activities in negative, okay? There you go. Now, let's read the third example. This is the question example, Fatima.
Could you spell your last name?
Could you spell your last name, Fatima?
Is C-E-N-T-E-N-O.
Okay, very good. You didn't forget it from the last time, right? Okay, there you go. So in that case, when do we use can or how do we use cool in this case? Good question. Ah, easy. To ask very, very formally a specific information. In this case, it is asking about, you know, the last name. And the last example, we got it. Could we check the details from my order? ¿Podríamos revisar los detalles de mi orden? So you see, in that case, it's like when you ask for something to happen, but in a very formal way. Entonces acá es cuando ya hablamos sobre peticiones o solicitudes de manera un tanto formal. Okay. There you go. Now, let's move on. Let's move on with these examples, people. Now, do you remember the uses of may? ¿Recordamos cómo usar may? Can anybody tell me what are the uses of the word may? ¿En qué momento usamos may? Any volunteer?
Podría.
Ah, ok, podría. O también significa poder, right? Ok. And remember, remember. Exactly, right? It expresses possibility. And remember, it can be about simple present or it can be about future too, ok? Good. Vamos a preguntar a los que tienen la cámara apagada. It will be better, right? Let's see, Natalie, are you there?
Hi, teacher.
Hi, Natalie. All right, Natalie. Can you tell me, besides expressing abilities, what else can we use may for? ¿Para qué más podemos utilizar may?
Que no es como para una autorización o permiso.
For example?
Quiero ver de los que dio students may leave early.
Ah, ok. ¿Qué estamos expresando en ese caso?
Como un permiso o... no sé, o sea, quizás como una... Ay, no sé cómo decir.
Ok, listen. En ese caso no estamos solicitando permiso, estamos dando permiso.
No, ajá, no, a eso me refería, a dar como una autorización o un permiso. No es a solicitarlo, sino que es como darlo.
Ok, there you go. That's the way, Natalie. There you go. Now, let's see. Thank you, Natalie. Now, let's see another person that got the camera off. Ana María. Give me an example using a negative form with may.
No, no sé, teacher.
Why don't you know?
No me acuerdo.
And why don't you remember? Now, let's remember, Ana Maria, we put not, listen up, in this case, because may is an auxiliary verb, we can put not right after the verb, in that case, the verb may. Example, my students may not, listen up, my students may not miss the English classes. So, en ese caso llevamos not entre may, que es el auxiliar, y el verbo principal. En este caso va a depender de la acción que usted quiera hablar, así va a ser el verbo principal. ¿Ok? Example. Yes.
It's time to attend them.
What time is it? I got the cell phone off. Let me check. Ay, como no tengo el teléfono cerca, let me see. What time is it?
It's 9 o'clock at night.
It's 9? Okay, there you go. If it is 9, I'm going to stop in here for a moment and I'm going to check it. Just give me a second. So I'm going to pass the attendance list. Thank you for reminding me, Maritza. I am in 909. It was so interesting in the class that I was not paying attention to this. There you go. Let me check. Ana Claribel.
Present.
Okay, cool. Ana Maria.
Present.
Okay, nice. Carlos Ademir.
Present, teacher.
Okay, perfect. Eric Guillermo. Ay, that's weird. Eric is not in the class. Ever de Jesús.
Present.
Okay. Fátima Alejandra.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Hilmar Cruz.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Let me check. Jonathan Alexander.
Present.
Perfect. Jorge Elvir. I think Jorge had got some things to fix.
I am here and listen to the class. Oh, sorry.
Okay. There you go. Carla Benazir.
Present, teacher.
All right, nice. Okay, she is not here. Maritza Alcira.
Present, teacher.
Nah, okay, very good. Natalie Vanessa.
Present.
Perfect. Romeo Alexis.
Present.
Nah, okay, good. There you go. Let me check. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
Okay, good. Ruth Joanna.
Present, teacher.
Okay, perfect. Let me check. Sara Carolina. Sara's not here. Stephanie Lisette.
Present.
Okay, good. Vanessa Odette.
Present.
All right, there you go. William Alberto.
Present.
Okay, excellent. Nubia Zulema.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Roxana Yesenia.
Present, teacher.
Okay, good. Jennifer Noemi.
Present.
Okay, good. Let me check. And got the last one, Diana Gabriela.
Present.
Okay, good. There you go. So let's continue. Give me a second. I'm gonna put this. This is the one. Okay, we were in here, right? Now we got main in here in this part. Let's remember, main is mostly used for asking, okay, very formal, like, you know, permissions and also requests. But also may is used to show possibilities about something, okay? If I say, I may ask for a refund. Puedo preguntar o puedo pedir un reembolso, okay? And then we got the next example. You may buy at a different store, all right? Como tú puedes comprar en una tienda diferente. They may not provide a good service. Ellos no pueden proveer un buen servicio. It may not reach your expectation. No cubre sus expectativas. No puede cubrir sus expectativas. So this is pretty much what we got about the examples of may. Just remember, this is just a short feedback. Now, let's move on. Might. That was another topic that we were discussing. Okay, last class. It was like two classes ago, if I remember.
This is the past of May.
That's correct. Yeah, this is the past of May.
Of May.
There you go. Okay. Okay, good. We got the examples in here. We got some examples in here. Okay, good. Let me check. Fatima, let's read the example number one.
She may want a refund on those units.
She might want a refund on those units. Okay, she might want a refund of those units. Okay, there you go. So let's remember, might is basically the past version of may. So that, in that case, might is like podría. Okay, so she might want a refund from those units. Ella podría querer un reembolso de esas unidades. Okay, then we got a second example. Romeo, help me read the second example.
El second member.
Yes.
Okay. They might complain about the service.
Okay. They might complain about the service, right? They might have a complaint, right? Podrían quejarse sobre el servicio. Okay. That might be the one. There you go. Thank you, Romeo. Jonathan, let's read the third example.
We might ask to talk with the supervisor.
Okay, very good. Very good. Okay, good. And then we got the last one. Let me see the next example. Rosa, help me out reading the next example.
What?
Okay, let's read the next example, Rosa. The last one.
He might not buy here again.
Okay, there you go. Thank you. He might not buy here again. Es como que ella no podría o él no podría comprar acá de nuevo, right? So in that case, let's remember, might is just the past version of may. When do we use it? To express possibility. And in question, we use it just to express, you know, a permission or a request. That's it. Okay, we're not gonna step that much in here because it's something that we have been practicing during the past weeks. So I'm not gonna stay that much in here, right? Besides that, we need an activity to cover. That's why like I'm pretty fast. Where can you see this type of examples? You have them in the manual. Remember, these examples, you have them in the manual. Okay, let's continue. These ones are the ones that we were discussing yesterday. Bueno, estos son los que estuvimos viendo ayer, okay? Estos son los ejemplos que ustedes tienen en el manual. So that's why I'm telling you, don't copy them. Just read them, okay? Vamos a leerlos nada más. William, help me at reading number one. Using would. This is from yesterday's class.
I would change these products.
Ah, okay, thank you. I will change this product. Cuando usamos would, remember, to talk about past, okay, isn't that possibilities. Another one, to request something in a very formal way. And also to talk about possibilities, okay? That's the uses, or that, those are like the main uses of would, okay? So in the case in here, I will change this product, all right? It's like it, like cambiaría ese producto, right? That's for an ability that you might have. Then we got a second example. Nubia, help me out reading.
He will buy there again.
He will buy there again. Okay, there you go. So what does it mean? There is a possibility in the future that that person buy in the same store again. Ah, en este caso hay una posibilidad futura que ese cliente, okay, vuelva a comprar en esa tienda. There you go. Now, next example. Jorge.
Yes.
Let's read, Jorge, the third example.
We wouldn't stay in the place.
Okay, there you go. Now, in this case, this is the past version, right? Recordemos ya, esta es la forma negativa, okay, cuando usamos would. Would must not, en ese caso, el would más la palabra not, okay, suelen fusionarse. En ese caso, ya sería pronunciado como wouldn't. Wouldn't. Okay. We wouldn't stay in this place. It's like, no nos quedaremos en este lugar. Okay. It's likely similar to one example you did in the midterm. Es algo similar a un ejemplo que ustedes hicieron en el midterm, si no me equivoco. Okay. Solo que ahí estaba en una versión positiva. Creo, o negativa. Was it negative?
Positive.
It was positive, right? Sí, recuerdo que varios me preguntaron sobre ese. Yeah, I mean, there were a lot of people asking for that. Y la cosa es que a veces la plataforma, I mean, a veces actúa de una manera bien extraña las respuestas, porque a veces un puntito y la respuesta está todo incorrecto. O a veces una mayúscula y todo está incorrecto. Cuando eso suceda, prueben con otras variantes, ¿ok? En este caso, como estábamos viendo, would and would like, había una que en vez de escribirle simplemente el would like, le eliminábamos el like y solo quedaba con would, ¿right? Y había otra que era viceversa. Estaba con would like. Con would, y simplemente había que agregarle el like. All right? But that was depending on the context of the example. There you go. Now, in question. Let's remember, in question is when we request something in a very formal way. It says, would you give me your information? ¿Me darías información? Ah, aquí es cuando ya hacemos solicitudes o peticiones de una manera bien formal. Exacto. Bien formal. There you go. Would you give me your information? It will say, yes, of course, right? There you go. Now, would. And let's use would like. Would like to in this case. They basically are the same. Básicamente son lo mismo. Okay, básicamente son lo mismo. The only difference is that in this case we use like. En este caso, lo único diferente que la hace es que acá usamos like.
Like.
Yes, ¿y cómo usamos like? Recuerden, ese gustaría. That's the translation of it. Gustaría. Entonces, ¿qué sucede? Listen. Cuando usamos would, dependiendo del verbo que usemos, ese sería el tipo de traducción que daríamos. Ese ia que colocamos a los verbos. Si tenemos like, de gustar, tenemos would like, gustaría. Will eat, comería. Will love, amaría. Will sell, vendería. Ok. Will buy, compraría. Entonces ese will actúa como ese ia que se coloca a cada verbo. Ok. To express possibility.
Teacher.
Yes.
Mire, en el midterm. En la cuarta, allí está ese, ¿verdad? Donde dice, would you like, no me lo acepta, ya la probé de varias maneras y solo por eso no termino. Le tengo que quitar el like, dijo.
El punto.
El punto. Ya lo probé hasta quitándole el punto.
Pero así lo agarra, sin el punto.
Listen, Ana María. ¿Ah? Listen. Le voy a platicar una experiencia pasada. A ver, hubo un estudiante hace un par de a couple of modules ago, okay, que estaba un tanto así como frustrado, angry, porque nunca le daba la respuesta correcta y él decía, it is correct, I don't know what happened in this case, and bla, 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 bla. Yes, it was correct. Y de hecho sí estaba correcto lo que él estaba escribiendo. Pero ¿sabe qué era lo que pasaba? A veces se saltaba un espacio de diferencia. Y a veces un espacio que usted se salte, ya la respuesta está como mala. Así que le aconsejo que revise ahí, sí, que no haya ningún espacio o something that might cause that.
No, lo que decía Marixa es el punto. Ya lo quité. Y ya lo arreglé. Ya está.
No, que ya lo había probado.
Gracias, Marisa. Ya lo había probado, pero no me, quizás tenía un espacio.
En el chat, en el chat coloqué, porque algunos preguntaron y ahí les pasé la información.
Ok, ok.
Ya estuvo, ya lo arreglé. Gracias, Marisa.
Okay. Bien amable.
Ah, con que Jorge era el que estaba dando las respuestas.
No.
No, ahí opinamos en el grupo los dos. Ajá. Porque varios estaban consultando sobre ese problema.
Yes.
Ya ve, para que vea que estamos bien. Somos un equipo.
I'm gonna see who's the one that is sharing screenshots.
No. This moment I cleared all.
I got proof already. De esos, por eso es bueno tener WhatsApp Plus, porque ahí quedan los mensajes. Even if you delete them, Jorge. Nah, Jorge, don't believe that.
Hey, okay. Teacher, it's a thing.
Yeah, I know, no problem, man, no problem, right? Okay, let's continue with this. Check these examples that you got in here. I would like to change this product. Ah, me gustaría cambiar este producto. He would like to buy there again. Ah, a él le gustaría comprar ahí de nuevo. They would like to come back here. Ah, a ellos les gustaría volver acá.
No. No.
¿Cómo es?
No le gustaría.
Ah, there you go. Es la única que está despierta, people. So you see, and everyone is sleeping. Right, Jennifer?
Jennifer and the
fire. Cuando sea grande, quiero ser como Maritza.
Okay. Eso.
Listen up, Maritza.
Stephanie has it.
Okay, there you go. Yeah, that's the negative version. Remember, they wouldn't like to come back here. So it means a ellos no les gustaría regresar acá de nuevo. Mm-hmm. Probably because it was a bad service, right? And then it says, would you like to get a refund? ¿Les gustaría tener obtener un reembolso? Okay, that is a, you know, a very formal request or offer in this case. Okay, good people. What are we gonna do now? Ahora, básicamente ya hemos estado viendo todo lo relacionado a los temas principales que habíamos estado estudiando esta semana. Okay, now, what are we gonna do? I want you to open up your manuals. Ahora lo que quiero es que nos vayamos a sus manuales, okay? Specifically to the page 27. Yes, the page 27. This page. Yeah, this one. Vocabulary practice. ¿Qué vamos a hacer acá? Listen. Lo voy a explicar así de una manera un tanto general, ¿ok? ¿Por qué? Porque nos vamos a ir a trabajar y, you know, in couples, in pairs. Yeah, actually, probably we're gonna do it in groups. Let me see how many people are you right now. Give me a second, I'm gonna check. 21. Ah, okay. Sí, creo que lo vamos a hacer de tres. Listen, what are we gonna do here? It says vocabulary practice. Okay, this is the vocabulary practice that we were doing at the beginning of the lesson. Tenemos acá un par de frases. Dice, match the different steps to follow when making an online purchase. Lo que vamos a hacer acá es a mature, right? In that case, enlazar. How come? Estas frases de acá, vamos a completarla con estas frases de acá. ¿Cómo así? Example, tenemos login. Login, recordemos, es entrar o registrarse en algo. ¿Ok? Login, y acá podemos escoger la que mejor, ¿ok? Se puede enlazar con esta frase, de login. Login, y acá, ¿cuál sería?
For your account.
Ah, log in to your account. There you go. Entonces, simplemente vamos a match those things. Pero como les mencionaba, lo vamos a hacer en grupos de tres. We're gonna do it in groups of three. Para que así podamos, you know, like, be sharing answers and all those things. Para que podamos hacerlo todos en grupo. Okay. There you go. And when you finish that part, cuando terminemos esa parte, and pay attention, y pónganme atención, ok, pay attention. No estén escribiendo porque luego no me van a entender. Ok, ya van a tener tiempo de escribir. Vocabulary practice, we got the vocabulary practice over here. Bien, tenemos una práctica de vocabulario acá, extra. Dice, ask different partners valid reasons why customers can ask for a refund. And reasons when they cannot ask for it. ¿Qué vamos a escribir acá? Listen. Aquí tenemos name. Acceptable reason, unacceptable reason. Good. Como vamos a estar trabajando en grupos de tres, supongamos que Fátima, Carla y Vanessa están trabajando juntas. ¿Qué va a ir acá? Listen. Acá puede ir el nombre de Fátima, acá el nombre de Carla, y acá abajo el nombre de Vanessa. acceptable reason. Acceptable reason de qué. Razón aceptable de qué. Acá me van a escribir una razón válida, ¿ok? Del por qué un cliente puede pedir un reembolso, ¿ok? Sobre un producto. ¿Cuándo un cliente, según ustedes, puede pedir un reembolso? Me van a escribir una razón, ¿ok? Aceptable acá. And an acceptable reason. Y una razón por la cual no se le aceptaría o no podría pedir un reembolso. ¿Ok? One positive, one negative. Eso por cada uno. Ok. When you finish that, cuando ya terminemos eso, ¿ok? Cuando ya terminemos ello, nos vamos a venir a esta sección acá. This will be the last section that we're going to be working on. Dice, demonstrative pronouns. ¿Ok? Demonstrative pronouns. ¿Qué tenemos acá? Dice, read the description and write down the correct demonstrative pronoun. Tenemos this, that, this, and those. ¿Recordamos esto? Yes. Estuvimos haciendo una práctica hace un par de minutos atrás. What are we going to do in this case? ¿Qué vamos a hacer en este caso? Listen. Tenemos un par de ejemplos. Dice, how could you buy something like? Y ahí tenemos que seleccionar si es this, that, this, and those. ¿Cómo vamos a identificar eso? Listen, listen. Lo vamos a identificar de esta manera. Acá en paréntesis, tenemos lo que básicamente la esencia para identificar si es this, that, this, or those. ¿Cómo así? Dice, talking about a purse in your hand. Ah, la oración o pregunta habla sobre un bolso en sus manos. Entonces, ¿cuál será ahí para completar la pregunta? This, this. That, this, and those.
This. This.
This. Utilizando el this de singular, no de plural, ¿ok? De singular. Entonces, esa frase que aparece o esa oración que aparece en paréntesis es la que los va a guiar. Si dice far, es that o those, dependiendo si es singular o plural. Ok, si es algo cerca, near o close, ah, entonces es this o these, ok, dependiendo si es singular o plural. That's what you're gonna be doing, ok. There you go. Bien, vamos a comenzar con esa parte. What are we gonna do? Bien, ahora nos vamos a enfocar entonces, voy a separar los grupos en la score work. And I want, listen, and I want everybody to work, okay? I want everybody to work. Let's go for it. Yes, I got it. All right, I think I messed up with this. Give me a second. I think I'm gonna stop in here. I need to recreate more breakout rooms. Okay, I just created a couple of them. Just give me a second. 1, 2, 3. Okay, I'm gonna check them. Okay, let me see. Permítanme que estoy recreándolos acá, que creo que necesito agregar más. Okay, we got 7. Yes, I need to have them with 3. 4. Let's see if we can work. Okay, give me a second. We got two and we got two. Okay. Okay, how many we are? Okay, one is missing. So I'm gonna put Anna into registry number four. Okay, bien. Démosle aceptar and let's go to work. Let's do it as a group, okay? Ruth, are you there? Okay, perfect.
Hola.
Le tomaron captura o tiene que ir el manual.
Sí, tengo el manual. ¿Y usted?
Ah, pues no. Voy a compartir la, la captura. Tal vez me regañe el teacher.
Rosa, what is that?
Lo siento.
Jesus Christ, Rosa.
Aprender a ignorarlas igual que yo. No te quieres. La sociedad de los mundos que hemos visto. Para eso tendrían que dejar de juzgar y hacer algo productivo. Eso
no se puede. Ok, have a weather. Ok. Let's start with that, okay? Vamos a comenzar con ello entonces. ¿Qué vamos a hacer en este caso? Listen. Las parte de las frases que tenemos en el lado izquierdo de su pantalla las vamos a completar con las partes del lado derecho, okay? That's what we're gonna do. Si tenemos log in, remember, log in to your account. Okay. Si dice confirm the method, confirmar el método, ¿cuál sería la siguiente que va a ir unida a ese? Rosa, Ruth, Roxana.
Efectivo,
tarjeta de. ¿Cuál sería?
Dijo confirme. ¿Cuál fue lo que dijo, teacher?
Bien, lo que pueden hacer es comenzar desde la primera que está arriba. Dice credit cards. Ok, pero después de credit cards, ¿cuál sería de las que tenemos acá a su derecha?
Information.
Credit cards, information. Very good. Perfecto. Entonces, así básicamente es la forma en cómo vamos a ir llenando cada una de ellas. Después de haber terminado acá, recordemos, vamos a pasar a la siguiente serie de ejercicios, ¿ok? Bien, si, si necesitan ayuda, just let me know, ¿ok? Simplemente le aprieten ahí el botón de ask for help.
Ok.
Ok, good.
Sweet on pavement, on like web page information, the price, the portions. Okay. Information, entonces.
Yo creo que sí, este es. Enviar es submit.
Submit. Okay.
One question. Romeo, are you there? Romeo, ¿les está ayudando?
Sí habló, pero no sé.
Romeo, are you there?
Okay.
Me voy llegando.
¿Hola?
Me había levantado un momento.
Ah, ah, okay, okay. There you go. Ok, perfect. Sí, porque ahí recordemos, okay, los tres tenemos que estar aportando para poder terminar, ¿ok? There you go. Okay. So, tenemos 17 minutos para poder terminar todo, ¿ok?
Ok, teacher.
There you go. Okay. So that's why you're working you three, ¿ok? Cool.
If you need help, select items.
Show me.
Teacher, vaya, esto era lo que teníamos que hacer, ¿verdad?
Yes. Okay, let's see. Credit cards information. Okay, very good. Confirm your information. Billing address. Como que no me suena mucho esa. Confirm your information.
Confirmar tu información. Tal vez en white, ¿verdad?
Ok, después de confirmar la información, ¿qué hacemos? Ah, le damos enviar. Yes, esa sería.
Okay. Y escribe billing address, right? Billing address.
Yes.
Entonces, ¿cuál sería?
Confirm your information, submit.
Ah,
yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Right. Billing address.
Para este Pachuca ya. Vale, aquí asume.
Sí.
Okay. Bueno, entonces ya no sé. Igual.
Igual sería billing
address. Va.
Select the items to purchase. Go to the online webpage, write the billing address, check the price, confirm the method of payment, right, and log in to your account. Ah, very good. That's the way.
Awesome.
Okay.
Yes. Ahora sí. There you go. Now, let's continue. Ahora bien, continuemos.
Ok. Ahora esto. Marisa.
Hola.
¿Qué sería?
And another things we can say of, I don't know.
También yo pensé, porque podría ser. Porque no cumple con sus expectativas el producto.
por producto en mal estado.
También.
For product in bad condition.
And the first one, factory defect or defecto de fábrica. The first one. The second is cambio de parecer, me dijo, ¿verdad? Ya no le gustó la camisa. Ya no le gustó la camisa, se la va a cambiar. Ajá. Entonces sería
no me quedó la prenda que yo quería, ¿no?
Ajá, it's a reason and I don't like the short, maybe. Not like the teacher.
You don't like me?
Pero no es que...
Teacher, sorry. It's teacher. Teacher. Sorry. Teacher.
Yeah, man.
Teacher. Pero no es que no me guste. La prenda sí me gusta, pero no era mi talla, no me quedó.
I know. Sigh. Maybe the size is not
for me. Is different
or no is for me.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Okay. Maybe Nudia. Pero ¿cuál vamos a poner en su caso?
Porque no, como es de reembolso, no tendría que hacer cambio.
No podría ser cambio por cambio. Sí, vea.
Bueno, ajá. Porque como ahí dijo que era reembolso.
Ajá.
Vale. Por producto expirado. O sea, ya pusieron el de...
Dañado.
Dañado, ajá.
Pongamos pues, que expiró.
Ajá, por producto expirado.
Ajá. Y el otro podría o sea, ser... la fecha de caducidad.
Ajá.
Ok, entonces Natalie.
Sí.
Ana María.
No, Natalie. Y en el último nos vamos conmigo. Producto... expirado. Uno es dañado, el otro expirado y el otro puede ser ¿qué le puedo poner?
Mental. Ay, igual porque yo tampoco trabajo en ventas, así que ingeniársela de lo que uno me escucha.
Va, entonces en este caso colocamos los nombres de las tres. ¿Cómo se llama?
Perfecto.
Rosa. ¿Y la otra persona?
¿Cómo es eso?
Rosa.
¿Cómo se llama Rosa? Ah, come on, just Rosa and that's it.
Entonces, Rosa, Juan Carlos.
Juan Carlos.
Mentira,
Rosa. Come on. Why are you talking about people?
Rosa.
Juan Carlos nos va a dar un ejemplo.
Yes, of course. Okay, acceptable reason. ¿Por qué puede un cliente pedir un reembolso? Okay.
Cuando el producto dañado.
Damaged product.
Salió deficiente. Por ejemplo, una licuadora. Sí, se supone que es 10 velocidades y a la hora que le va a licuar no le licúa lo que...
Los frijoles.
Ajá, o no licúa bien la fruta, entonces él no satisface las necesidades del cliente. Entonces,
ajá,
ahí,
good.
Producto... Insatisfactorio. Mejor, más corta y más fácil, producto dañado.
Veamos. Damage product, right, teacher? Mm-hmm. Or not?
Y yo digo que la razón por la que no se puede aceptar sería producto con descuento.
El que Roxana menciona sería, el que Roxana menciona es básicamente ese que les acabo de poner en el chat. Así sería.
Ahorita, vamos a ver. The product don't work as it says it work. Como no está trabajando como... ¿Qué?
Ajá, el producto no funciona como dice que funciona. O como dice en el manual.
No trabaja como debería de trabajar.
There you go.
Ok, llamo. Super. A product doesn't work as it says it works. A ver, otra razón. Empecemos con las inaceptables. ¿Por qué otra razón no le aceptarías el reembolso?
Una puede
porque él lo haya dañado.
La otra puede ser de que productos en descuento no...
Porque ya pasó la garantía. Ya no puede haber un reembolso, ¿verdad, Ticha? Entonces vamos a ver. Finish the warranty. No.
Ya, yeah, let's remember. Yeah. Si el cliente es el que daña el producto, la garantía no aplica. The guarantee is not, you know, applicated.
Warranty is not applicated. Aquí vamos con las razones inaceptables.
Pero es que estamos haciendo una y deberíamos de ser por persona, deberíamos de ir haciendo para no confundirnos.
Yo ya me confundí escribiendo el cuadro que no era.
Ay, no. Vaya, empecemos.
Póngale una flecha.
No, qué barbaridad.
Primero con mi... Yo más que todo estaba haciendo la mía, vaya.
Ajá.
Le había puesto damaged product. Producto dañado. Ajá. Y inaceptable, le puse discounted products have no...
¿Y a usted?
Hola, teacher.
Hi.
Hi, teacher.
Teacher, ¿puede poner la slide de número 3? Porque yo no la
copié. Estábamos esperando, teacher, como agua de mayo. Para que nos pusiera, sí, para que nos pusiera la parte 3 de la actividad.
Hey, ¿quién me la escribió esos corazoncitos ahí?
No sé,
fíjese. No sé. Usted lo está compartiendo.
Ah,
yo
estoy compartiendo algo, pero yo no sé por qué le aparecen eso. Yo no lo hice.
Ah.
No, el teacher, ¿eh?
Usted lo hizo.
Yo acabo de conectarme acá.
Usted lo está compartiendo.
No, yo no.
Ah, no.
Yo lo estoy compartiendo, pero yo no sé por qué le aparecen esos corazones.
Ah.
Discúlpenme, yo no pude.
Ajá.
Unos cachitos le hubiera puesto a María.
Sí. Ah, no, yo no era.
Qué valor, qué valor. Ok, what do you want me to share?
La última slide.
Ah, ok, give me a second. La última slide, ok. Estamos hablando del manual, ¿cierto?
Sí.
Sí.
This yes. Part.
Yes.
Ah, eso estaba.
Ay, esta cosa. Okay. La copia usted.
Sí, ahorita le tomo captura.
Bueno,
yo
también.
Vaya.
¿Ya?
Yeah. Sí, okay. Teacher. No quedó mal, no quedó mal.
Ajá. Let's focus because we got very, very, very short time.
Ahí está. Vaya. Ya la pueden ver, ¿verdad?
Sí, pero hágalo más grande, muy chiquita la hizo.
¿Ya sé?
Sí.
Ahí sí.
Bien.
Falta. ¿Está bien así?
Me la voy a comparar, voy a ver si a mí, allí. Ahí está bien, Natalie.
Ahí está bien, vaya. Teacher, ¿y ahí qué vamos a hacer?
Simplemente escribir.
Ya.
Y ahí los la oración que está en paréntesis le va a indicar si es this o that para singular, si es this o those para plural, ¿ok?
Ok. Ok.
Ahí la primera dijeron que era this.
Yeah.
Esa es la que hicieron allá, ¿verdad?
Sí, en clase.
Segunda dice reports are heavy. This. Porque ahí es plural.
With a pile of people.
Ahí puede ser this, ¿verdad?
This. This report are very cheap.
I have to wear this is comfortable shoes I bought during a long walk.
Comfortable shoes.
Mm-hmm.
Comfortable shoes.
This is. No, el otro. ¿Cómo es cuál es la diferencia entre this is y el otro que es?
This, creo.
This
is and these are. This is for singular, these are for plural.
Okay. Pero ahí es, ahí sería this. Or this is. Pienso yo, this.
Number two?
Sí. No, no, allí es singular, allí es plural.
Okay, dice, with a pile of reports on your lap, con una pila de reportes en tu pierna. Okay, dice, reports are heavy. Ah, this. Pero la forma plural. Yes.
¿Verdad que sí? Okay. La número tres, ¿cuál es? ¿Dos o this?
I have to wear comfortable shoes about during a long walk.
That sería, ¿verdad, teacher?
Where, number three?
Sí.
I have to wear that comfortable shoes I bought. Dice, during a long walk. Ah, durante un largo, largo. Paseo.
Camino.
Paseo. Ok, I have to wear these, porque los lleva puestos, básicamente. Pero this, el plural, ok.
Very porque good. Son dos. Exacto. Porque es shoes.
Exacto. Ok, I will give you 2 minutes for you to finish, ok. Right after the 2 minutes, we gotta finish.
Okay, teacher.
4.
So hey, what's happening here, people? Did you finish? The last one. Dice, in y luego picture. You see my wife and daughter. Dice, en paréntesis, about a picture hanging on the wall. Ah, estamos hablando sobre una imagen o fotografía que está pegada o trabada en la pared.
Esta es la imagen o foto. En esta foto puedes ver mi esposa y
mi hija.
Ah, hija.
Hija.
Como en este caso está hablando de la pintura, va. No está hablando de la persona.
De la pintura.
Sí, está pues hablando, sí, o sea, no, de la foto, va.
Ah, yes, es la foto. Ah. All right, there you go. In this picture, you can see, okay, you can put it that way.
Y en las cinco, así sería.
Those are Mr. Pineda's children. About a picture hanging on the wall. Sí, básicamente es una fotografía que está igual, colgada en la pared, okay? Y puede utilizar those también en ese caso. Aunque si usted quiere, también puede utilizar this, pero ya la forma plural.
Okay.
There you go. Okay, you finished already, right?
Yes.
Yes.
Okay, what time is it? Okay, I think you're gonna... I think...
Attendan, teacher.
Creo que en este caso... no, I need everybody to be in the same way, in the same room to take the attendance list, okay? Básicamente, ahora sí, ya nos vamos a la sala principal para pagar asistencia, right? Rest of I'm gonna check. Close all rooms. Hey, why are you crying, Ana Maria? You look like you're crying like this way. I don't know what you said. Okay, let's see, everybody's coming.
No, no estoy llorando, le digo.
okay.
Estoy cansada, tengo la vista cansada.
Ah, right. Sudando por los ojos. Okay, there you go. Okay, what are we gonna do, people? We're gonna check very quick what we have, all right? And right after the checking, we finish the class, okay?
Okay.
Let me see. I'm gonna project the screen. I think we got this one, okay? And we got this, we got this, we got this. All right, there you go. Yo voy a mencionar, listen up, voy a mencionar la frase acá y ustedes me mencionan la frase con la que se complementa, okay? Cada una de las oraciones. For example, we got credit card.
Information.
Okay, very good. Credit cards, information. Where is your information?
Uy. Ahí está la moto.
El bus. ¿Quién pidió pizza? Pollo campero.
Pedidos ya.
Tiene voz de comercial. Pedidos ya.
So nice. Okay. Confirm your information.
Submit.
And then submit. Okay, very good. Mm-hmm. Select the item or items.
To purchase.
Okay, to purchase, go to the
online webpage.
There you go, right?
Billing address.
Billing address.
There you go, check.
The price.
Confirm the method.
Payment.
Of payment, very good. Log in.
To your account.
Ah, okay, very good. To your account. There you go. Now, let's see some acceptable reasons. Vamos a leer nada más un par de reasons que ustedes tienen, okay? Just some of them. Ever, what do you have in that case?
Only what?
Only the acceptable reason.
acceptable reason the factory defect.
That's the acceptable reason. Okay, very good. Jorge? In that case, the opposite, an acceptable reason.
And the product under factory warranty.
Ah, okay, very good. Fatima, acceptable reason?
Is does not meet your expectation.
That's an acceptable reason?
Yes. Como no cumple mis expectativas el producto.
Si supongamos que usted saca una ¿qué? Refrigeradora y usted se la lleva y le dicen, tiene un año de garantía. Y luego usted dice, ay, no me gusta esta refri. ¿Cree que le van a hacer el cambio de con la garantía?
No, pero, o sea, porque ya es demasiado tiempo, che. Pero dependiendo del tiempo, o sea.
Una vez usted acepte y apague y la saque del lugar, that reason is unacceptable sometimes.
Ah, okay. Pero eso quizás aplicable aquí al país, en Estados Unidos.
No hay problema.
No, I mean, that's allá. Different. That's completely different.
Allá usted I mean, la puede ver hasta que llena de comida.
That is another world. Yeah, I mean, that's completely different. But in here in El Salvador, you cannot do that, right? Yeah, okay. But it's okay, Fatima. That's pretty cool. Jennifer, an acceptable reason?
For late delivery.
You like?
For late delivery.
Ah, for late delivery.
Para la tarde.
No, okay. Yeah. Right. Okay, might be possible. Okay, let's see the last pair. Vanessa, what do you have?
Okay.
An acceptable reason.
Acceptable reason because the product doesn't work.
Ah, okay, the product doesn't work. Okay, and Hilmer, let's do the last one. An acceptable reason.
An acceptable reason, bad handling of the products?
No, okay, all right. When you don't use appropriate the product, right? Okay, very good. Now, let's see the demonstrative pronouns. Okay, let's check this part. Okay, number one is already done. It says, how could you buy something like this? Okay, this is, let's remember, that one is
singular.
The singular version, yeah, that one. Like these, okay. Number two says, reports are very heavy. Y dice, with a pile of reports on your lap. Ah, con una pila de reportes en su pierna. Okay, ¿cuál es el que tengo que usar acá?
Do.
This plural.
This is plural.
These, porque están cerca, los tengo en mi pierna prácticamente, okay? Yeah, very close from me. That's why. Okay, number three. I had to wear, y luego dice comfortable shoes I bought. Y luego paréntesis tiene during a long walk, durante un largo paseo, caminata.
Go.
Recordemos, usamos those para mencionar algo que está lejos de nosotros.
Lejos.
These.
Yes, in this case, we got these. For plural. Number four. You bring me, y luego dice, cup I left in Anna's desk, y luego dice, pointing at a cup of her desk. Okay, that, porque está lejos, right?
Mm-hmm.
Very good. Number five, are Mr. Pineda's children?
Dogs.
Pueden usar those o pueden usar these, okay? Both of them are acceptable. Ambos están, son aceptables. Check, I need to move on with this. Ah, what happened? Ah, okay. All right, we got that one right. And let's do this one. Okay, number six, incest. In, and you got picture, you see my wife and daughter. Okay, podemos usar this y podemos usar that. Okay, let's put this. Pero this en singular. This one, right? Very good. So then you have the answers to these questions, okay? So tomorrow probably we will finish this couple of questions that are missing, okay, from the next exercise. But right up to now, we're going to finish the class because it's like, you know, time. I have moved on with the time with you. Good. Before we go, antes que nos vayamos, hemos completado todo lo de las tareas en la y el examen.
Yes. Yes.
Yes.
Missing. Okay. Para los que todavía les faltan, por favor, los voy a estar esperando después de clase. Okay. ¿Por qué? Porque antes de medianoche yo tengo que hacer este reporte. Nah. Okay. All right. Very good, Jonathan. There you go. Now, let me pass the attendance list and we basically finish the class, okay? Give me a second. So we got Ana Claribel.
Present.
Ah, okay. Ana Maria.
Present.
No, okay. Then we got Eric. We don't have Eric, right? Carlos Ademir. Carlos left one. Yeah, he's not here. Ever de Jesus?
Present, teacher.
Okay. Fatima Alejandra?
Present.
Nice. Gilmar Cruz?
Present.
Perfect. Jonathan Alexander?
Present.
Jonathan? Okay, good. I think we got Jorge Elvir?
Present.
All right. Carla Benacer? Hey, where's Carla? Carla, Ana, she's not here. Okay. Margot is not here. Maritza Alcira?
I'm here, teacher.
Okay, listen up, Maritza. Como Carla no está y le tocaban los 10 minutos de feedback, usted es la que le sigue, okay? Entonces, ahora me voy a quedar con usted, Maritza, en the 10 minutes feedback. Y mañana le va a tocar a Carla, que mañana era el día suyo, ¿ok?
Okay.
We're gonna switch. Okay, perfect. Then we got Natalie Vanessa.
Present.
Okay, Romeo Alexis.
Present.
Okay, good. Rosa del Carmen.
Present.
Ah, okay, you got it there. Rose Joanna.
Present, teacher.
All right, thank you. Sara Carolina is not here. Stephanie Lisette. Stephanie Lisette. Ah, okay. Why are you not answering, Stephanie? Vanessa Odette.
Present.
Okay, very good. William Alberto. Okay, William got some issues. Roxana Yesenia.
Present, teacher.
Okay, very good. Nubia Zulema.
Present, teacher.
Good. Jennifer Noemi.
Present.
Nice. Diana Gabriela.
Present.
Okay, very good. There you go. So, what do we need, people? As I told you, all right, I need, for the ones who have not finished with the homework, let's finish, okay? And tomorrow, we will start basically the week three, okay? So that's gonna be everything for tonight, people. Thank you for joining to the class, and let's see you tomorrow, okay? Bye-bye.
Bye, teacher.
All right, bye. Okay, bye-bye, everybody.
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye. I saw the message, Mrs. Urrutia. Supongo que tiene problemas con el audio, así que no hay problema, right? See you tomorrow. Okay, just give me a second. Gonna put and let's see what's up in there.
It's Stephanie.
Stephanie, are you there? Let's see, because I need to move on. I'm gonna put something. Okay, yeah, she left already. All right, Maritza, what are we gonna do? We're gonna have 10 minutes, okay? With those 10 minutes, it's up to you, or it's given to you, you know, to ask any question that you might have related to the class, related to the topic that we have been discussing and the previous topics that we studied. So I don't know if you have any question related to the class, Maritza.
Hi, teacher. En Spanish le voy a decir porque.
All right, go on.
No, yo le entiendo mucho sus clases y todo, pero si se ha fijado últimamente mi estado de salud no ha sido bueno, pues no he llegado a un buen final, pero sí trato la manera de ir repasando ahorita. Pues estoy cumpliendo con la clase, ¿verdad?
Ah, muy
pero,
bien.
Pero yo mañana yo repaso lo que hemos visto ahora para tratar de irlo entendiendo y busco otras opciones para entenderlo. Yo ahorita, hoy tuve una crisis por la mañana que quedé cansada, ¿verdad? Que casi no puedo hablar mucho. Uh-huh. Entonces, ahí estoy completando yo la clase. Yo le entiendo mucho, yo quizás un 80% yo le entiendo su clase, pero mi problema es la conversación.
Ajá, that's the
ya problem. Cuando, si me pregunta o algo, ya, yo siento que ahí me bloqueo y se me olvida qué tengo que responderle.
Ajá, that happens because we need to practice more, right? Uh-huh. Entonces, uh-huh. ese tipo de sucesos pasan cuando básicamente nosotros necesitamos practicar más. Entonces, uh-huh. no hay una suficiente práctica en ese tipo de situaciones o contextos. Entonces, uh-huh. ¿qué es lo que vamos a ir haciendo más seguido? Vamos a ir haciendo un poco más de prácticas, ¿ok? Uh-huh. Y vamos a implementar un poco más de prácticas con relación a conversaciones. Así, uh-huh. pues, poco a poco vamos a ir agarrando un poco más de fluidez, ¿ok? Y soltura al momento de hablar. Eso es lo que vamos uh-huh. a ir haciendo con estas uh-huh. semanas que faltan. Así, de cierta manera, podemos practicar el vocabulario que de cierta manera vamos a ir adquiriendo con cada uno de los temas. Uh-huh. Okay.
Sí, porque yo siento que, me falta vocabulario, pero estar escuchándolo, uno se le queda. Yo estoy tratando de ver películas en inglés, aprovechando hoy que estoy aquí en la casa.
Uh-huh.
Canciones en inglés.
Ah, that's good. That's really
que,
good.
Que hay ciertas palabras que, por ejemplo, unen. Uh-huh. Eso en las canciones se escucha bastante. Uh-huh. Cómo se unen las terminaciones y los inicios de las otras, ¿verdad?
Ajá, ajá.
Pero como normalmente solamente español hablamos, pues se van quedando esas cositas.
Exacto, exacto. Eso es lo que pasa y a veces por eso es que nos cuesta el poder tener un poco de fluidez al momento de hablar. Ajá.
Uh-huh.
Y no es que no conozcamos las palabras, sí las conocemos. Lo que pasa es que al momento de hablar no las sabemos articular. That's what happens. Eso uh-huh. es lo que sucede.
Sí, porque yo me bloqueo y yo después digo, ay, no, sí, sabía qué era, pero no, ya para la conversación, ahí sí yo siento que ya me cuesta más.
Ajá, ajá. No, pero sí, como le digo, poco a poco vamos a ir venciendo esas barreras a través de la práctica. Because you have vocabulary a lot. Entonces, porque usted básicamente ya tiene vocabulario, entonces lo que se necesita es un poco más de práctica en ese aspecto. Yes, mm-hmm. That's what you really need, and that's what we're gonna be doing in the following examples in classes.
Okay, y teacher, pero hay algo que usted me pueda recomendar que yo pueda bajar en internet para ir como como educando más el oído o practicar más.
There is a channel on YouTube that you can go and practice in there. It's called like that. Okay, you can take a note on it, or I can send you to the chat on WhatsApp, right? That one is pretty cool because you can practice pronunciation. Aparte de los ejemplos que se dan en la plataforma acá, en el sistema, puede acceder a ese canal, right? On YouTube and
YouTube TV.
All right, in that case, you might practice in there, okay? Because in there, you can practice the most the pronunciation. Okay. Entonces ahí digamos que como que ayuda un poco más a la pronunciación de las palabras, cómo se pronuncian las palabras. Okay, hay ciertos versos de palabras y eso es, de cierto modo es bastante bueno el conocerlos. That would be one. Yes.
Okay, teacher. Only practice.
Yes, practice, that's what we need, exactly. Es básicamente lo que necesitamos para ir mejorando poco a poco.
Yeah, only teacher.
All right, that's it. Con respecto a lo del examen, ¿cierto? Ya con usted ya está todo.
That's yo ya terminé el examen, solo esa pregunta de ahora era la que no.
Ah, perfecto.
La oración que no podía ya.
Perfecto.
Ya completé, entonces. Ya completé.
Muy bien, las ya tareas estoy. Están hasta la tarea 10, ¿cierto?
Sí, las discusiones hasta las que usted ha puesto, tres
excelente,
nada más.
Excelente, excelente, entonces ahí está
las
todo.
Las discusiones, entonces. Las tareas, excelente. Ya voy en el 48%, creo, 38, no sé.
There you go, muy bien.
Sí, ahí excelente. Vamos completos.
Excelente, entonces, that's all we need to know then in that case, Maritza. So, entonces mañana vamos a comenzar ya la semana 3, así que vamos a entrarle con todo, como decimos, ahí a los nuevos temas, ¿ok, Maritza? Entonces, let's see you tomorrow, Maritza. Have a wonderful night, ¿ok?
Good night, teacher.
Bye, bye. Okay.
Gracias por su apoyo, teacher.
Ya sabe, para eso estamos siempre. Ok, bye, bye.
Bye, bye.